Hey guys, it's your boy Grippers, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool promo where last I left off. I picked up wins over Spurs and Northampton in the FA Cup and the Capital One Cup, respectively. In this episode, I have a game against Sunderland, and hopefully I can get to the game against West Ham. In this episode, unfortunately, in between this game and the West Ham game is the January transfer window deadline day, which I want to get through relatively quickly. Hopefully I can. I'm not going to be doing any business unless a player leaves on loan, or maybe I get a bid for one of the players I have listed, but I'm not going to be, you know, haggling. I'm not going to be looking for crazy amounts for the players I've listed. If I get an offer, unless it's completely unacceptable, I'll probably accept it. Then, yeah. But I want to talk about the devastating loss. Dutch and Barcelona legend Johan Cruyff has passed away at the age of 68. That was staying lost in the world of football. If you're like me and, you know, you didn't grow up, watch. If you grew up after the time of Johan Cruyff, please go watch him. Highlights of him playing on YouTube, because the man was a genius. Like, when he had the ball, everyone praises Messi, guys like Messi and Ronaldo, who just know what to do when they have the ball. It comes like a human instinct. It's like instinct to them. They just know. Cruyff was amazing at doing that. And I mean, he is such a legend in the world of football, but he'll never be forgotten. There's even a skill move named after him called the Cruyff turn, which is one of the most well-known skill moves in the game. And of course, a legend for Barcelona and Ajax as well. Oh, Cruyff, amazing player.
And that could have been
we'll never be forgotten. Amazing player. Very sad to hear this. And I think I speak for the whole football world, you know, from fans to, I think I can safely speak for some of the fellow players who grew up watching Cruyff, some of the modern players who have grown up watching him, and some of the players who played with him, and more alongside him or against him. I mean,
to win the league, they're getting themselves in a good position.
You'd be hard pressed to find someone who did not appreciate Cruyff, who's on field, old genius. And like I said, I didn't even grow up with him, but I know how good Cruyff was. Watching highlights of him on YouTube, it's just amazing to watch. Like, I'm in awe, and I'm like, wow. This is almost as good, if not better, than Messi and Ronaldo. It's just, he just clicks. He's like, he can, like, when he was at his best, Cruyff could have probably gone into any team and made him 20 million times better. Like, we all praise how good Leicester are for the season with guys like Riyad Mahrez and Jamie Vardy. Cruyff was kind of like the Riyad Mahrez of his time. Except, you know, not more well known. Riyad Mahrez is, you know, just bursting onto the scene maybe this season. But Riyad Mahrez, right now for Leicester, sets up everything. Everything whom Leicester create, goes to Riyad Mahrez. Cruyff was like that. Cruyff dictated everything. Yeah, really looking forward to this one. We're going to see some good football. He was brilliant. United did score in that match, Alan McDonald. And like I said, I think I can speak for just about everyone. If you have something bad to say about Cruyff, then you do not respect the game of football, my friend, and you should not watch it. Because the man is a legend. The game probably wouldn't be what it is today if not for guys like Johan Cruyff. So, they'll probably never see it, but this video, but I think I can speak for everyone in the league, from players to fans, who say our prayers and thoughts are with the family of Johan Cruyff, and he will never be forgotten, true legend. He will be sad missed. I kind of almost wish it had happened on any other day, because today is kind of like sullied with the fact that a certain other footballer who pretty much ruins the reputation of the modern game by doing his filthy actions off the pitch, and you know exactly who I'm talking about, got 6 years. 6 years only. How the hell did he only get 6 years? Granted, yeah, he did kill someone, but I would have given him 15 to 20 years. There's 6 years. If he gets out before the 6 years are up, he should stay in prison for a long, long time, because the fucker is a horrible bastard. And it's ironic that I'm actually playing Sunderland, because that's the team that kicked him out. It riles me up that
keeper didn't have to move to make that save.
That today is probably the only time you would ever hear someone mention, I'm not even going to say his name, in the same breath as a guy like Johan Cruyff. Pathetic.
Having the ball. Corner kick given.
So let's just forget about the low-life scum.
Keep the build-up going to sustain the pressure. But goes for it with a fist.
Who went to prison today and talk and take time out of our day to remember her football legend like Johan Cruyff.
That's beautifully done for the goal.
The keeper, quite rightly, is disgusted with his defenders because they've just not helped him out there.
Well, that was a brilliant goal from the Artemans. It's put me 1-0 ahead. Having it super unlucky with all sides in this match. Got a few there in the first half.
Coutinho. There is going to be a change here. It's going to come from Sunderland. The referee's given the free kick.
Oh wait. Oh, I thought he gave the foul again. Yeah. Here comes Lee Clatmore.
Royce. Fine cross.
Royce hits the ball off for Genie. Here's Marvius. I probably said that guy's name wrong. Bridge cut. There we go, Ricardo. Yes. Foul. Free kick. No.
Oh.
was that no free kick?
Alan McAnally's got to tell us about from
what? Oh, never mind. I've still the ball. Fine. There's also the ball. All right to bail.
Left an easy tap in. 69 minutes, please. 4-1.
Thank you very much, Alan.
Yeah. Denmark.
Slipped his man.
Here's a chance.
Oh, brilliant.
Cora will ever have thought that he was going to get a goal quite like this one.
Takes it past the keeper. The keeper dived down to take the ball. Pulls from Neymar. Neymar's like, nope. And he just slots it out with the greatest of ease. It's not a real surprise. I mean, I can easily beat this goalkeeper. It's Bogdan. Yeah. I just really took notice of that. It's Bogdan. What on earth are you thinking, Sunderland? Like, I don't even realize this old Pantermon, for whatever reason.
Made the save.
Bogdan. How badly do you want to be relegated?
Just looking at Sunderland, what about the next game, Alan?
The guy who was
City in the next match in the Barclays Premier League.
So shit, he got dropped.
Royce,
you're shit enough to get dropped and replaced by Mignolet. No matter what team you play for, or you don't even deserve to wear keeper gloves.
Goal news from Norwich, Alan McAnally.
It's the second goal for Chelsea. 5 minutes remaining. 2-1.
Interesting news again from Alan McAnally. Tackle there is successfully done.
Yeah, just hit it off our own player there, Gareth.
Oh, the goalkeeper.
Yeah, I'll take that. Get rid of that. Easy,
that's been signaled now. Referee does
No, it's not the full time, so he's getting a free kick. I'm wondering where the scoreline was disappearing if that was full time or so. Okay, there's the full time, so everything is gone now. 2-0 win. Not the biggest win I could have pulled off. And Arsenal picked up their win over Watford. Brilliant. So we got this still. 20 points. Ah. Okay, and will this, I don't care. Okay, we have an offer with Fadiba Origi, who I don't want to sell, so piss up. Imagine if that had been a little tough for some movie. Yeah, I don't know. That would have been weird to see Sutherland come back in for the English right back. That's close. Just gonna let the clock tick down. I have no moves to move. I think it's too late to do any moves now. It's definitely too late now. What is your
You have to make an offer. It has to be good enough.
Why it's 10 hours instead of 20? Should be 24 hours. and a little Jim White should come on at the end in a white, in a yellow tie. That would make the game a million times better. We got through that deadline day relatively quickly. Very happy with that. It means I can get straight into this West Ham game. West Ham are in the bottom three, so if they were to get relegated this season, this might be my last game at the moment.
Right.
Because, of course, it won't be in this. Well, I assume it won't be in this, yes. But considering West Ham won't be there, it might be in the game for the nostalgia feel. How cool would that be to have, like, old stadiums in the game? Like, you could have the old Wembley, you could have Highbury for Arsenal fans. And the bowling could stay in as a classic stadium as well. Why not? Why not? Why the hell not?
West Ham United's lineup is this.
Adrian. It's one of the most recognizable stadiums in the English Premier League, especially considering West Ham are finishing the top four.
And that's good support as they build this attack.
That's in real life, of course. Like I said, in the game, they're in the bottom three. Even having Payet isn't helping us end the game.
Ricardo Rodriguez. Real good contest between these two as they jostle for possession. Royce out on the wing. So just nip in and spot the pass or attempted pass and win it.
Okay. Take yes. Royce. Boom, bottom corner. A brilliant start. 9 minutes in, and the German makes that 1-0. How you like that, Payet?
What a strike that
yeah.
was.
Just put his foot through it. They've got Payet, but I've got Marco Royce. Who needs Payet when you've got but a brilliant German? My efficient French players are in centre back.
Payet.
Literally, but my centre backs are French.
Nathaniel Clyne. Correa. Change of possession here. Couldn't keep it in play, it's gone out for a throw. Orellana.
Ball to Neymar. Oh, brilliant ball to Neymar, and they missed! Fucking missed! Oh, the brilliant ball to Neymar. Effect up. My bad. Oh, after Laporte's amazing pass. Oh, by me. With Stevie G. Oh! Doing a bit of a slip on himself. Tim Lenz! Oh, he went for the same thing he did against Sunderland. It's come to Neymar. It's in. And Bale can't get on that. He throws through it. It's very fun. Not sure who, but I wasn't sure who had that. I wanted the header, whether it was Bale or defender.
know that it was Rito Bono. I wasn't paying attention to him. I must sound bad to his body. Oh, speaking about boom, bottom corner, turn now. Oh. Yeah, what's that you do about? Oh, yeah. How does he do against Gareth? Well, the less said, the better.
Restarting at 2-0.
It really should be 3 if I hadn't mucked up on the Neymar shot after the reported pass. I no one to blame but myself. It wasn't my fault.
Sekou Kouyaté.
O'Brien running down the wing, and that is a terrible cross from the left back. I think he's Irish. I don't know why I think O'Brien might be Irish. Or am I thinking of somebody else? I might be thinking of somebody else, to be fair.
Well, the visiting team were very, very big winners the last time.
Wait, who?
No two games of football are ever the same.
Intimidating atmosphere here, the crowd anxious not to see a repeat. So,
is it Orellana? Whew, freaking hell, that was close. Carroll scored again. Of course, he scored. Yeah,
Bale.
Did that not go out? I was going to say Carroll scored in real life against Liverpool. The January League when that was going to go over us. It was Pug Bonner who still doing it in the FA Cup match.
Chunk of added time here, 3 minutes.
It's Tillemans who bangs it! Ooh, all off of Bonner. Confidence is high in the Belgian.
Another look at Bale's goal.
So I thought, why not? But it's come to Tillemans again! Ooh, yeah. The force to save from Adjaer. Just on Tillemans who collects it. It's Neymar on the edge of the box. And Coyote is the lock. Shot. And pass is not going to matter because it's half time. See, Arsenal aren't playing. Brilliant. Tomorrow.
It's the kickoff here for the second half.
I'll have to wait and see how they get on. Don't know who they're playing.
Oriana.
But I can rule out West Ham because I'm playing West Ham. It's nothing to do with this. Oof! Carroll again? He's getting first. Too close for comfort. Uh-oh. Give him the turn of it, and it, and oh my god. What have I done? What did I... Oh.
No chance of getting a hand on him.
Oh. It's two stupid things I've done in this match. The miss with Neymar in the first half, and the short goal kick. There we go, Neymar quickly. He rectifies that. Restores my 2-goal lead, and gets the goal when he was owed it from the first half.
3-1 the scoreline as we restart the game.
Yeah, let's not be so lackadaisical this time. Don't do anything stupid in defense again.
Hendrick. And back it goes to the goalkeeper. Throw in for Liverpool.
Way.
Ricardo Rodriguez.
Marquez to the Mets. Then Klein. Also, I was lining up the shot. Was sure if he wasn't right in front of me. Bell. Can I get a short away now? Boom! Yes, I can! Bell scores his second of the game. Him. And boom. Yeah, 4-0. 4-1, sorry. It should be 4-0. Really, it should be 5-0. I digress. Simmons. Crap.
Neymar.
Brilliant casting. Neymar. Thought I'd walk into the box.
Well, some news today involving the Italian club Lazio. They've completed this deal.
Well, 35.
So my own old Frenchman. Yeah, there we go. A foul of Frenchman Varane. Wait, Coutinho will somehow go away with the ball there, but Royce's shot was, yeah, that's then brilliant. Oh, come on! There's Cresswell. I'm not sure why he didn't start. Maybe he's coming back in.
It's another miss. It's been an opportunity miss for this team.
Ooh, wow, that was so close. That was almost a second for Valencia.
It's a good challenge by West Ham to get the ball back.
Get rid of that. Oh, Klein, you fucking...
Able to deal with that quite
calm. Don't scare her like that, Nathaniel. God damn it. Oops. That's a red card. Oh, that's a red. That's got to be a red. Oh wow, it's a yellow!
For the next game.
That looks certain. I thought for certain that was a red. I got away with it, lads.
A little bit from where we're sitting because the game as a contest is long, long over.
Well, I won't exactly have gotten away with it if they get it over in this. And they haven't. Brilliant. Correa. Neymar, is he gonna get there? Is he gonna get there? Oh, Cresswell had to do his best to prevent what would have been a controversial career goal. I still think he might have easily been sent off. Maybe to keep the, not the keeper, the referee, was lenient. Who the referee is, but can he referee some of my other games, please?
Kuyate. He's cut out the pass.
Correa.
Go on the attack.
Oh, Coutinho. Go two pass. Yeah, the pass was too heavy for Coutinho to make an impact on it, and it doesn't matter. Some poor her decision. Mistakes by me. Miss here from Neymar. Oh my god. I still don't. I have no words. All I can say is it was totally my fault. I mean, I pressed the shoot button and I don't know how I missed. I really don't. And then the end of Valencia goal. What was I doing?
Valencia, and this is a goal!
And that, boys and girls, is why you never kick your goal kick short. Something I have to learn once again from the hard way. And another conscious decision. I don't know. I'm his manager, and I probably would have given Correa a red card for that. If any West Ham fans are watching me, let me know. Was that career foul? Was that a red card? Because it looked a red card to me, and I'm his manager. And the referee gave a yellow. So, I don't. Maybe someone else, maybe someone in the comments can explain that to me, because it looked the red card. It really did. Training session before the end of the episode. I didn't actually inch away from me. He won. So I have a Leicester in the next episode. I'm gonna calm him down a bit earlier. Inadvertently, really. It's true that Frankfurt's playing a really smart. Arsenal have already played, so either they drew at the weekend and won the match that they played before me. Come on, I can figure this out. Okay, they drew this against Crystal Palace, so they picked up the win at the weekend. It was West Brom they were playing. They were 3-0. West Brom. But thanks to Crystal Palace, I have now chance in the next episode, I have a chance to go 12 points clear. Oh, I do not mind if I do. Wait, what? Okay, not 12 points, 22 points.
Derp.
Hashtag Corey needs glasses. Thanks for watching. Oh, enjoyed. I'm gonna go lie down because I'm clearly not in the right state of mind considering my poor form in that West Ham game despite the win. And the fact that I cannot do simple math today. So brilliant. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe for more videos very soon. Until next time, I hope you all have a very, very